We are discussing snail mucin. Should it be part of your skincare or not? Let's go. So there are two snail mucin products which are really popular in the beauty spectrum, right? People give me feedback that I use very big words. I'm going to try and simplify it to more conversational English. I'm sorry about that, but now that I know, I'll try and do it better. So there are two brands which are very commonly used by a lot of us. The first one is COS RX and second one is the Mizon. I'm going to be referring to COS RX as COS and Mizon as Mizon. Both of them have very good reviews and very good followers. People swear by both these products very, very passionately. So let's first just understand what is snail mucin. Now, snail mucin was actually created by a doctor who was an oncologist or a cancer doctor, and he created it to help his patients who used to get a lot of skin issues, dermatitis, basically where your skin barrier breaks, you have dryness, irritation, inflammation, sensitivity. And he found that when they put snail mucin on the skin, it kind of eased the skin out a lot. It really helped and smoothed out the skin and gave them a lot of relief. And it was able to do that because snail mucin is packed with a lot of great ingredients. So is snail mucin equal to hyaluronic acid? It's not. Yes, both of them are great moisturizers, but that is where the comparison ends. Snail mucin has a lot of other ingredients packed into it. Apart from the fact that it has hyaluronic acid, it also has allantoin, which is an emollient. It's got collagen and elastin, which help build up your skin. Then it also has glycolic, which kind of helps your skin cell turnover very easily and rhythmically. And it also has a whole lot of antibacterials packed into it. So to compare it with hyaluronic acid is actually no comparison at all. They're two different product categories, two different ingredients completely. There is no comparison apart from the fact that both hydrate your skin very, very well. So now that we have that out of the way, let's talk about snail mucin. Why snail mucin is great for your skin? It's great for your skin because, like I said, it has got allantoin, which makes your skin smoother, softer, and kind of nourishes your skin. So you need that when you have very dry skin, sensitive skin, or when you have irritated skin. Then it's got elastin and collagen, which are the building blocks of skin. Basically, it helps your skin remain strong and healthy. So having extra collagen and elastin on your skin helps when your skin is repairing itself from acne scars, pigmentation, irritation, or psoriasis. And that is where, remember, we said it helped for patients suffering from cancer. This kind of soothes over the skin and helps repair the skin barrier, the elastin and the collagen. Then it's got glycolic, which helps your skin remain healthy, young cells turn over as rhythmically as possible. And it's got antibacterial, which means that if you're using it as part of your acne care, it actually helps in calming your skin and bringing down the bacterial activity which can make acne worse. So snail mucin is a great addition to your skincare if you have pigmentation, acne scarring, if you have sunburns, if you have very sensitive skin, if you have dry skin, if you have irritated skin, if you want to use it as part of your anti-aging regimen because it's got collagen and elastin. It's great if you're looking at recovering your skin from neglect. So if you've not been able to use your products for some time and your skin is looking dry and dull, it's a great comeback for there. And last of all, it is of course great product for hydration. So, a great addition to your skincare. There is this question of whether it is ethically mined. Both Mizon as well as COS RX have gone on record and said that they've ethically mined it. But you know, there's always gray areas around it, whether you should use it, not use it. But that's entirely a very personal choice. A lot of us are vegans, a lot of us are vegetarians, a lot of us are non-vegetarians, a lot of us are a combination. So it's a very personal choice on what is it that you are comfortable with. I started using the Mizon's snail mucin some time back, and I actually stopped using it in between till I had dermatitis because of some contact with the product, which suddenly became irritating to me, and it really helped repair my skin. So I introduced it back into my skin, and it is something that I think was a very foolish decision for me to have stopped it in the first place. It's beautifully hydrating, as you can see, and it goes in as a nice film, so it's great to put under your moisturizer. And because it does nothing wrong, it's not photoactive or doesn't react with the sun at all, it's something you can wear morning and night, which is the kind of help you require when you're suffering from acne or pigmentation, or if you have very dry, sensitive skin. So, and even as an anti-aging practice, the good products you want to use morning and evening so that your skin has those products available for most of the day or night when it repairs itself. So it's a great addition. I quite like it, and I have reintroduced this back into my skincare. I think so should you, especially if you're looking at repairing your skin and you're looking at anti-aging benefits. Now, which is better, COSRX or Mizone? I think both products have a legion of cult followers, which really means that they have fans which will either use this or this only. They will not interchange these two snail mucins. And if you go to the Asian Beauty on Reddit, I'm going to leave the link in the description below, and there you'll find a very balanced opinion. You'll find people who love COSRX and people who just love Mizone. And there are people who hate COSRX and people who hate Mizone. So skincare is very, very subjective. What works for me may not work for you. What works for you may not work for me. So unfortunately, we all have to try. Despite the fact that we hear a product recommendation from someone we really like and admire, ultimately, you have to know your skin and you have to give it a shot of whether this product is good for you or not. I think within the first 15-20 days, one gets a fairly good idea whether the product is going to work for your skin or not. So that's it. If you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, please do subscribe. And a lot of women who write to me for beauty concerns actually share with me how troubled their personal life is because of the skin and hair. That is so sad. It just makes me so sad to hear that, you know, that it can affect your personal life so badly. So I want to be able to contribute to some of these causes. And if you're able to make another person's life happier, why not? So with that, I wish you a great day ahead. Be good to your skin and hair. Till I catch you next time. And take care of yourself, guys. Self-care is the most important.